Bomdia, bonjour. J'avimos as clases de características de Mariel en Schwarz para variedades singulares. Hoje vamos continuar nas clases características com outra definição, outra construção, que é a construção de Macpherson. So, let's speak English. So, today we will go to Macpherson classes, which is another construction for characteristic classes of singular varieties. And well, let's begin. Let's begin. Opa. Okay, so this course will be with three guys, Macpherson himself, and Nash, and Mazur. Mazur, you know already, this guy was present for stratifications. And Nash, maybe you know Nash. There is a famous movie about him. I don't know English the title, but there is a famous movie. Maybe you have seen. So these three guys, in fact, Macpherson uses construction, previous construction made by Nash and by Mazur. So Macpherson constructed classes, in fact, as an answer to a conjecture by Deligne and Grothendieck. Let's remember that Marianne Schwarz defined her classes in 1965. And the conjecture by Deligne and Grothendieck was in 1969, and Macpherson classes in 1974. In fact, with Marianne Schwarz, I was very happy to prove that the classes are not anything else than Schwarz classes previously defined. And so currently it's sometimes we say that Marianne Schwarz was able to prove the conjecture by Deligne and Grothendieck before they give the conjecture, 4 years before they give the conjecture. The Macpherson construction uses, as I said, previous construction by Nash and by Mazur, and he uses also a new ingredient, which is local Euler obstruction. Many people in Brazil are now working on all this class on the local Euler obstruction. That was the case for Roberto Bedregal. So, again, we look at the complex situation, M, a complex analytic manifold, and X, an n-dimensional semi-analytic complex variety inside M. We call the regular part of X is X minus the singular part, okay? We will use the Grassmannian manifold of complex n planes in CM, GNCM. There are various notations in the literature, so for me, I will take this notation, GN of CM. And of course, if you have a tangent bundle to M, if you look at the tangent bundle of M, you can associate the Grassmann bundle, GN of TM, which over each point in X in M, this GN of TM is the set of n planes in the fiber TX of M. So in fact, GN of TX of M is isomorphic to GN of CM, okay? Well, an element of GN of TM is a pair XP, where X is a point in M, and P, a point in the fiber, so P is an n-plane in the tangent space of X of M at X, okay? So you have this here. So GN of TM is a fiber bundle of this is the set of n planes in all fibers of Tx of m. T of m, the fiber is, T of m is m dimensional, okay? So, for the over the regular part of x, in each point of the regular part of x, you have an n plane, which is tangent to the regular part, because x is dimension n. Okay, so gamma of x is the pair x, of course, which is a point in also in m, and the tangent bundle, the tangent fiber, sorry, the tangent space to x reg at the point x, which is n dimensional, so it is well an element of Gn of Tm of at x. Okay, so you have this map gamma in Gn of Tm, and you can take the closure of the image. So image of gamma, and you take the closure. That gives you x tilde, which is a subspace in Gn of Tm. And this x tilde is can be projected on x by nu. And in fact, if x is an analytic variety, of course, it is, or not of course, but you have to work a little better. But it's possible to show that x tilde, the closure of the image of gamma, is an analytic variety. It is in general not smooth, so we have to take care. It's not smooth. X is singular. X tilde also, in general, is singular. Okay? This is an image. For the moment, we look at the bottom of this picture. We will look at the paper part later on. Here is X. X is a double cone. Okay? And I take for each point X, you have the tangent space to X, which give a point in X tilde. This point X tilde. So X tilde here is the tangent space to a regular point of X. So this is X tilde. This X tilde here is the tangent space to X at X, which is a regular point. Okay? Well, so you take the image by gamma, which gives you a cylinder minus this circle here. And if you take the closure, it is a full cylinder, because for A, if you take this singular point A, if you take any directrice line of the cone and the limit of tangent space to A, this will give you A tilde. A tilde, and all limits, in fact, all possible limits of regular of tangent planes at regular points in the cone, all the possible limits gives you, in fact, a circle as well as the regular, what happens on the regular part. So in that case, X tilde is a cylinder, so it's smooth, but as I said, in general, that's not the case. So take care of that. Well, so this is called the Nash transformation, X tilde. Now, on Gn of Tm, you can take a bundle, a true bundle, which is E, and this bundle is defined in the following way. You know that a point in Gn of Tm is a pair of a point X and P. P is a n-plane in Tx of m. Okay, so you will take the fiber over a point xp of Gn of Tm. That will be the set of vectors in the n plane. Okay, so you have a point here is a pair xp, and you will take all points, all vectors v in the n plane. So this will be, this gives you a fiber at the point xp. So you have a true vector bundle EP, and you take the restriction to ELDA, to this Nash transformation that we have defined. Okay, so you take the restriction. If you take the restriction, it gives you E tilde, and E tilde, in fact, will be the product, fiber product of these two guys over Gn of Tm. We have already seen what is the fiber product when you have such a diagram when I defined the pullback. So here it is the same, it's a product E by X tilde, but with identification of two points if they have the same image in Gn of Tm. So what does it mean? It means that is the set Vx. Vx is a vector in EP, okay, here, V of X, and X tilde, a point in X tilde, so a point here, Vx, a point here, X tilde, such that the two images are the same, so such that V of X here, which is in the plane P, is inside X tilde. Okay, so V of X belong to X tilde. So to resume this, an element of X tilde will be written XP V. XP is in X tilde, it is in Gn of Tm, and V is a vector of P, okay? And P is an n-plane in the inverse image of nu minus one of X. Is it clear? If I go back to the image here, E tilde will be here, okay? So first of all, I have here, oh, I don't know if I can. Oh, yes. Okay. So here I have over X, I take the union of all Tx of V alpha. We have seen that this is not a bundle because the dimension differs according the strata. But this is in Tm restricted to X. Okay, which is a real bundle restricted to X. Okay, so for example, here it's a singular point A. The tangent bundle at A is a point. Okay, it's zero. But if you take a point X here, you have the tangent bundle of V alpha at the point X, which is this plane here, and the point X, and I have a vector, I take a vector V of X, which is inside Tx of V alpha, okay? Now looking on this side, we have seen the Nash transformation, which is X tilde, okay? Which is in that case a cylinder, but as I said, it's not always a smooth manifold, can be singular as well. But over each point, here, I have the fiber of E tilde, so I have a true vector bundle, and all fibers are the same, are homeomorphic, and over the point X tilde, I have this fiber, which is homeomorphic, this is the same thing than Tx V alpha, when X is a regular point. In fact, here in the stratum V alpha, okay? So this here is the same than here, this. But over A tilde, I have also a fiber, which is homeomorphic, but the projection will be a point here, Ta of the point A, okay? So come back here. So E tilde is the restriction of this bundle E over Gn of Tm. This bundle is called, this bundle E over the Grassmannian is called Tautological Bundle over the Grassmannian. I have no time to explain the reason of tautological, but this is the bundle, the more simple you can think when you have a Grassmannian bundle, Gn of Tm. The bundle, the simplest you can think, this will be here, such that the fiber at a point xp is just the set of vectors in this plane. Okay? I think this is not so difficult. So the Nash bundle is this E tilde over the Nash transformation X tilde. Well, so now let's define the ingredient that MacPherson has defined, has used. It is the local Euler obstruction. Many people I said in Brazil are working on this local Euler obstruction. What is Euler obstruction at a point of X? In fact, if you take here singular X, you take the Nash transformation nu, okay, and you can define a nu star, which is here. Opa, nu star is this map from E tilde to union of Tx of alpha in Tm of x. You have a map here, which is just, if you wish, this map is just lifting on this map here, okay? And so nu tilde is here, going from E tilde to the restriction of Tm to x. Nu tilde, so you know that an element in E tilde, in the Nash bundle, is a triple x, x tilde, which is an n-plane, and vx, which is an element of this n-plane, okay? And nu star will be just the pair x, v of x. Of course, one did not say, is that on the regular part of x, on the regular part of x here, the plane P you take in Gn of Tm is just the tangent plane, which is n-dimensional in Tm of x, okay? So this is just Tx of the tangent plane to x, the regular part of x at x, x being a regular point. So in fact, you can see that if you wish, this x tilde is an extension taking all possible limits. Well, so we have this picture here. The proof of this is very easy. I let you, it is in the intended course, but maybe it's good to try to make it as an exercise to prove this, that a stratified vector field, which is defined on a part of X, admits a canonical lifting. See, if you have a vector field here, which is a stratified vector field, you can lift as a canonical lifting on the inverse if V is defined on a part A of X, V tilde will be defined on the inverse image of this part. And this will be a section of the bundle E tilde. Okay, you have here a true bundle E tilde. So each V can be lifted in V tilde in that way. The image of X, X tilde, V of X is X, V of X. And I said that defines the new star always also. And it's very easy using the Whitney condition A. Using this condition A, that you can lift any stratified vector field defined on a part of X on the event inverse image of the part of X in V tilde. You can lift in that way. This is a nice exercise which shows also the new use of Whitney condition A. Okay, so in fact, the Euler local obstruction, or local Euler obstruction as you wish, was defined by MacPherson using differential forms. in so he was using the gradient of the distance, some differential forms in that sense. But with Marie and Schwarz, we gave another definition, which is the same definition but translated in vector for vectors instead of vector fields instead of differential forms. So the definition is the following: you take a radial stratified vector field at a point. I say the point zero at any point, say zero in X at a point X, and you take what I call a basic radial stratified vector field. It means that it is going outwards of a small ball, it is stratified, and going outwards of a small ball around the point zero. Okay, so it is pointing outwards this ball, and it is transverse to all strata. That is a consequence of so-called Bertini-Sad theorem. So this the boundary of the ball S epsilon is transverse to the strata as well as your vector field. So you can define in the following sense. I will call, hope I come back to my picture here. So I have this picture here. I have a stratified vector field. As I have no many dimension, I cannot put many strata, but you can imagine that this vector field going outwards the small ball around the point, which is A here, but zero, if you wish, as you wish, it's going outwards the ball. And so it has index one, okay? That is in M, in the ambient manifold. So the ball is in M and your vector field is going outwards and stratified. So you can, by condition A, you can lift this vector field as a section here, as I will say here, as a section of E tilde. So your vector field, you lift as a section of the tilde. What does it mean? It means that here I have to each point x tilde, I associate a point in the fiber of E tilde at x tilde. Okay. Here I associate a point in E tilde, a tilde being in the event image of the point A. And as I remember you, this is the set of all limits of tangent plane to the regular part when you go to A. Okay. Well, so now here I have a vector field V tilde, which is a lifting of V on inverse image of X in trisection S epsilon. Sorry, I have to. So if you take inverse image of this, you have on the inverse image of the boundary of the ball intersection with X, you take the inverse image. So you take inverse image of this, okay, which is here. But take care that here I have only one regular part, but it can be stratified. But this is not a problem. This will give you here inverse image. And of course, you have also inverse image of the ball intersection with X. That means you have intersection of this cone, conic part, which gives you here, it's smooth, but in general it is not. So you have the inverse image of the ball intersection X. And you can lift by the lemma, you can lift this vector field on the intersection of X with S epsilon, you can lift by condition A of Whitney, you can lift. So you have a section nu tilde, which is defined over the inverse image of the boundary here and here. And you want to extend this section V tilde, which is defined here and here, and you want to extend over all inverse image of the ball. Okay? If you want to extend, you have an obstruction, and you can compute the obstruction. You can extend this section with isolated singular point. Okay? And that will give you a co-cycle. And this co-cycle, you can evaluate on the fundamental class, fundamental cycle, which is the cycle of, I will show you, okay, hop. Here, okay. So as I said, you take V over X intersection S epsilon, the over intersection with the sphere. You lift as a section of V on the inverse image of X intersection S epsilon, and you want to extend over the inverse image of the ball, inverse image of X intersection the ball. But this will give you a cocycle that you evaluate of the orientation class, which is a fundamental class that we have seen a fundamental class. So of, I give a fundamental class of a space, but you have fundamental class of a pair, which is the orientation class or fundamental class of this pair. So in to give a resume, Euler obstruction will be the obstruction for V tilde to fill up. Sorry, I had to put here. So it is the obstruction when you have this vector field here, you lift here, which is well defined, and you want to extend inside, and the obstruction to extend inside, that is exactly the local Euler obstruction. Okay. Well, so local Euler obstruction, of course, if you have a regular point, this obstruction will be equal to one because you have isomorphism. And in general, Euler local obstruction can be any integer. Okay. Well, so first of all, this local obstruction is one if you have a regular point. That is exactly what I said now. It is constant. That is a theorem which has been shown by many people, in particular by Marianne Schwarz and myself. The Euler local obstruction is constant along the strata of a Whitney stratification. And you have proportionality theorems that they are very important, that theorems that we have shown as well, that if you take instead, for the moment, I took a vector field which is going outwards the ball. But I can take any stratified vector field with an index here, which will be not one. It's one because I took a vector field which is going outwards the ball. But take over the ball a vector field with any index, stratified vector field with any index. Then the obstruction to extend inverse image, which is well defined by condition A of Whitney. So the obstruction to extend your vector field inside the inverse image of the ball will be exactly Euler obstruction times the index. So this is a proportionality theorem, which is very important. Used by many people in also other field, used for other characteristic classes, which is very important. The proportionality theorem for vector fields. If you take a vector field with index one, as I said, going outwards the ball, you have the Euler local obstruction. If you take now a vector field which is as any index, the obstruction for filling the inverse image will be the product of the Euler obstruction by the index. It's a proportionality theorem. And this proportionality theorem is also true for airframes, because now if you take an airframe, radial airframe, with isolated singularities on the two P-cells, with an index that we have seen, what is the index in the previous course, at the Barry Center, then the obstruction to extend your the lifting as a section of E tilde A will be exactly the product by the Euler obstruction at the point, singular point. E tilde A, of course, I did not say, but it is the bundle over X tilde associated with E tilde and whose fiber on X tilde is a set of air frames whose vector belongs to the restriction of E tilde to X at the point X tilde. Okay, so an element of E tilde A, instead of having X P V, will be VR, where VR is an airframe in P. So it is an obvious generalization to airframes of what happens when you take a vector field. Instead of a vector field, you take this airframe. And the proportionality theorem says that you have exactly the same formula for airframes. But now you have to take intersection with the cell di2p, exactly what we have seen for the in the construction by Maria and Schwartz. It's clear? I think that is not so difficult to understand these proportionality theorems, which are fundamental. We need another ingredient to go to the definition of Macpherson, the definition of a constructible set and constructible functions. What is a constructible set? A constructible set on a variety, a singular variety X, is a subset obtained by a finite union, intersection, and complement of subvariety. This is a constructible set, for example, is a triangulation. And the constructible function is a function such that inverse image of any, so it's a function of X to Z, and such that, to X to Z, such that inverse image of any element in Z is a constructible set for any n in Z. So it is easy to see that constructible function, you have the constructible function one everywhere, which is that will be useful, in fact, in the following. The characteristic function is a constructible function. Characteristic function on every subvariety of X is a constructible function. Also, if you take a triangulation of X and you take a function which is constant on each simplex of X, open simplex, a function which is constant over each open simplex is also a constructible function. So if you take such a variety X, so this is exactly what I just said now. A constructible function, if X is triangulable, phi is a constructible function if and only if there is a triangulation of X such that phi is constant on the interior of each simplex, or if you prefer, on the open simplex. And such a triangulation of X is called phi adapted. Well, if you take the correspondence associating to each X singular and subanalytic space in M, you associate the set of constructible functions. This is obviously a contravariant functor when you consider the usual pullback. If you take a morphism f from x to y, and if you take a constructible function on y, for example, alpha will associate to each point in y an integer. Alpha will be like that. And so if you take the composition alpha composed with f, that will give you a constructible function on x. So this is a usual pullback, any constructible function on y defines a constructible function on x. That's clear, so you have this pullback. But we will use a covariant functor, and the covariant functor will be considering the push forward defined on characteristic function on the following way. If you take the constructible function one over a part a of x, what will be F star image, direct image, push forward of 1A. That will be a constructible function on Y. So I will associate to each constructible function on X, a constructible function on Y. And the image of the constructible function 1 on A will be the Euler Poincaré characteristic of the inverse image of Y intersection with A. This for each point Y in Y. And this gives you a covariant functor from Fx to Fy. Okay? From constructible function on X to constructible function on Y. This is the definition of this covariant functor, which will be important in the conjecture by Dolinian Grothendieck. Okay, so, and in fact, this gives you, I have to complement a little, that gives you image of constructible function 1, but every constructible function on X is a sum of ni, ai, 1ai. Of course, so you can extend linearly this constructible function, this F star for each constructible function on X, okay? It's by linear. Well, so go to the Dolinian Grothendieck conjecture that is in 1969. I remember that Marie-Antoinette has already defined characteristic classes in 1965, 4 years before, and they give this conjecture. If you take the covariant functor of constructible functions, F, F here in the covariant way, and homology, which is also covariant, it is a usual covariant homology functor, okay? If you have a map X to Y, you have the map Fx to Fy covariant functor that we have seen now, which is a push forward. And for homology, you have homology of X to homology of Y, the usual covariant homology functor. And the conjecture by Dolinian Grothendieck says that there is a unique natural transformation of functors going from this functor to the homology functor, such that if X is a manifold, if X is a smooth, is a manifold, then the image of the function 1 over X, if X is a smooth, that will be the cup product by X, the fundamental class of X, of the cohomology chain class that we know very well when it is a manifold. We have seen that chain has defined cohomology class, but as I told you, taking the cap product by X, which is a Poincaré isomorphism, in fact. So the image by Poincaré isomorphism of the cohomology class of X defined by chain, this gives you an element in homology. And this element in homology is just C star of the function 1 over X. Okay. In fact, you can say the conjecture in another way, which in fact giving three properties. This, it says that if you have every algebraic complex variety, in fact, it is in the algebraic set, as I said here, framework. So you have a functor from constructible function to homology satisfying the following properties. C star of a sum of two functions f, phi, and psi, okay, will be the sum of C, C star of phi and C star of psi for phi and psi being constructible function on X. Okay, so C star of the sum is sum of the C star. C star of the image of phi image of fish. This image that we have seen here, sister of the image of a function phi. Here is we define for the characteristic function one, but you have by linearity for all constructible functions. So c star of f star of phi is f star of c star of phi for every morphism of algebraic variety. Okay. And f star being, of course, c star of phi is in homology. So here you have an element in homology of x, and you take the usual f star going to homology of y. Well, and the last is this the same here than here. Then if you have a manifold, so the image of the characteristic function 1 over x is just the usual Jahn class. Okay, unique natural in transformation is giving these two axioms here. Okay, so that was a conjecture by De Winning-Grothendieck in 1969. And then first people try to use so-called Mother classes. What are the Mother classes? I said my Mother also was implied in this. The Mother class of X, we have to come back to the definition we have seen of X tilde, okay, the Nash transformation. And you have seen the Nash bundle. So the Nash transformation X tilde and the Nash bundle on X tilde. Here we are in cohomology of X tilde because the Nash bundle is on E tilde. So you can take the Chern class. Take care, X tilde is not always a manifold, but we have seen that we can define characteristic classes, Chern classes, even if the basis is not smooth, when you have a vector bundle, when you have such a vector bundle, and E tilde is a vector bundle. Okay? So, in fact, you can take the Chern class of this vector bundle, which is in cohomology of X tilde. It's clear how we have defined this in the previous course. And you can take the cap product by the fundamental class of X tilde. That is taking a Poincaré map, Poincaré morphism, which is not anymore, X tilde is singular. But you can take the cap product by the fundamental class. So you have a Poincaré morphism going to homology of X tilde. You are in homology of X tilde by nu tilde star, by nu star, lower star. You go from homology of X tilde to homology of X. Okay? So, one, if you go back to the picture, I had to put this picture many times, sorry. Here, you have here E tilde, which is a bundle on X tilde. Okay? So, you take this bundle, you compute Chern class of this bundle, E tilde, which are in cohomology of the basis X tilde, which can be singular, okay? And you take, they are in cohomology of X tilde. So you take cap product by the fundamental class, you obtain an element in homology of X tilde, and by nu star, you go from homology of X tilde to homology of X. So you obtain an element in homology of X, okay? Well, yeah. Okay, sorry. Here we are. So by nu star, lower star, you go from to homology of X. So you obtain an element in homology of X. And this element is called the Mother class. The Mother class is I can say now that Mother classes were defined. I said to you that Wu Wensun, Wu, was also gave also a definition of classes in 1965, the same year as Marie-Anne Schwarz, but it was in Chinese. And, like Marie-Anne Schwarz wrote in French, Gouvenson in Chinese, so not many people look at this. And in fact, the classes that were defined by Gouvenson are exactly the mother classes than Macpherson defined in 1974. Okay, so you have the same phenomena that Gouvenson already defined these mother classes using other way than Macpherson, but it was already defined. Okay, so in fact, the Nash bundle X A tilde, in fact, cannot be it is a substitute to the tangent bundle in the case of singular variety. This gives you the mother classes, but the mother classes do not satisfy the Dolin-Grothendieck conjecture. So you cannot, they are very important. You will see maybe in the last course, and I hope I will give you the why they are important, I will tell you, but they don't satisfy the conjecture. There is a defect to satisfying the Dolin-Grothendieck conjecture. And the very good work by Macpherson is to understand why they don't satisfy the Dolin-Grothendieck conjecture and what is the weight we have to give to these mother classes in order to find a solution to the Dolin and Grothendieck conjecture. And the solution is through Euler local obstruction. We have seen Euler local obstruction of a point X, at a point X, in a singular variety X. But if the point X belongs to a stratum V alpha, you can take the closure of V alpha, which is not X, it's a part in X, but you can take the Euler local obstruction of the point at the point X of this closure V alpha, of the closure of V alpha. So this is also very well defined. We define it for X, but you can define from the closure of V alpha. Well, and then Macpherson shows that there are integers n alpha such that the sum of this n alpha Euler local obstruction at x to v alpha at for every point x in x, this is always one. So I had to put one x here. This is the characteristic function one. So there are integers n alpha which are contrary weight to the Euler obstruction to give everywhere one, okay? And this is not so difficult to prove this, to show this. And this was proved by Macpherson, a very nice proof. And then he had the idea to use not the local Euler obstruction, but this weight n alpha that provides, that gives you the function one everywhere, the characteristic function one everywhere, and to use this pawn n alpha to define a class. And the Macpherson class has been defined as the Macpherson class of the characteristic function one everywhere is exactly the sum of this n alpha that you can find here, this n alpha, and taking the mother class of V alpha. And the mother class of V alpha in homology of V alpha bar, the closure of V alpha, and you can go to homology of X, of course. The mother class of X is defined in that way, but you can take instead of X, you can take the closure of any stratum V alpha that will give you a class in homology of the closure of V alpha. And the closure of V alpha goes to X, so the homology of V alpha inclusion goes to homo geophix with this I. I is the inclusion here, and so you can define for the constructible function one everywhere on X. Now, by linearity, you can define for any constructible function phi, but a constructible function phi will be a sum of value of phi on a triangle, for example, times one on the triangle. So by linearity, any constructible function is a sum of characteristic function of the triangle where they are constant, open triangle, where they are constant. So you can define the Macpherson class for any constructible function by linearity, and the constructible function satisfies the Dolin-Grothendieck conjecture. Now, the Macpherson class of X, or X itself, this gives you Macpherson class of constructible function. For any constructible function, you have a Macpherson class. If you take the constructible function 1 over X, you have what is called the Macpherson class of X. Okay? Well, so as I promised you, in the next course, we will see that the Macpherson class is exactly the same than this class here, Cm of 1x, is exactly the same on the Marie-Lenchard class. And so, and we will see, of course, we will see that in the most detail I can give you. So this is a very nice thing that Marie-Lenchard was able to prove. In fact, during Grothendieck conjecture, we can say that before they give the conjecture. So thanks a lot, muito obrigado, pela atenção e fiquem bem.